Narayanam namaskritya maram chaiva namottamam devim saraswati vyasam tato devudhi gajananam bhutaganati sevitam kavitta jambu varadara bhakshitam umastam shoka vinashakaranam amami vigneshara pada pankajam Bhavadamabhattaram dhataram sapadampadam Logaminamam shrinamam kuyubhuyo namamiyam Arthanam artyantaram dhitanam bhayanajakam Dishatam kaladantam tam ramachandram namamiyam Ramaya ramabhadraya ramachandraya redhase Raghunathaya nathaya sitaya pataye namah Ujantam ramarameti madhuram madhurakshiram Arugya kavita achara ये वाल्मीकि कोकिलम् वाल्मीके मुनिसिंहस्य कवितावनचारिणः श्रृण्वन्नामकथानादम् उपनयातिपदम् गतिम् गोष्पदीगतवारीजम् मषकीगतराक्रतम् रामायणमामालारत्नं मन्देरिलात्मजम् अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीजमक्षहन्तारं वन्देलङ्काभयङ्करम् Amangal Hari Mangal Bhavan Amangal Hari Drau Sudashinat Ajir Vihari Drau Sudashinat Ajir to speak, he had managed to somehow convey to her that this is the king's command. the ashrama of Valmiki is nearby, and he's kindness, compassionate incarnate, and his father is known from the father's time and all of that, and that she should not think otherwise, and he had pleaded and all of that, and she had, it was like again as if a bomb had been exploded on her head and she had fallen down, collapsed. And then she had picked herself up and had spoken to him. And she had said that the Creator must have made this mind, body of mind, specifically for the purposes of sorrow. For you see that I am Dukkha Murti. I am the very suffering incarnate. And what sin must I have committed in the previous birth? Or before, I must have separated somebody from their spouse. Something I have done, for I am one who is abandoned, who has been deserted by the king, despite the fact that my conduct has no flaw. And she had pleaded with him, saying, it was all right before when I was staying in the hermitages, in the forests of Dandakaranya, because at that time I had Rama with me, but now I don't, how will I live without him, she had pleaded. And whatever will, and who, to whom will I be able to, speak of my woes, my sorrow, my grief, to whom will I speak? And what will I say when the rishis in the ashrama, they ask me, why has the king abandoned you? What will I tell them? What will I tell them? She had asked Ashrama. And she had said that I would, if you were left to me, I would do away with my life this very moment by offering myself to the waters of the Ganges. But then I can't do that, because with me will die the lineage of the dynasty of Rama. She is in the family way, so she says. Then she gathers herself. She had to literally bring out that message from Lakshmana. It was impossible for him to say it. She had in fact ordered him, saying, I order you, you tell me what is to say. Why are you crying? Why are you breaking down? Then he had told her. Now again she picks herself up now and tells him, Yadangyam kurusau mitre tyajamam dukkha bhagini nideshe sthiyatam rangya shrutir chedam vacho mama. O Saumitri, then Sumitra son, O Lakshmana, do as you have been ordered by the king. Yathangyam kuru Saumitri. The king has given you some orders. Do as the orders have been issued to you, obey them. Abandon me, who has someone. I am Dukkha Bhagini. My destiny is of sorrow. So you abandon me. You do what you need to do, which is to obey the orders of the king, and you can abandon me here and go away. But Shuru Chedam Vachumama, just listen to these words of mine as well. Take this message from me, from me back to Ayodhya. That's where we stopped last time, so we move forward from there. So she tells Lakshmana, making your bows on my behalf, at the feet of all my mothers-in-law without distinction, fold your hands in salutation and convey my greetings to them and to the king. To the king. And you should tell the king, who is firm in his adherence to Dharma, you know, O Raghava, that Sita is in truth pure. You know that. And that she is supremely devoted to you and intent only upon your good. And tell him my message. Tell him I said, I know you abandoned me. Because you are afraid of having your reputation ruined among the people. That scandal which would make your name a byword in the streets of Ayodhya. That accusation upon you which shall be talked about by the people at large. That should be dispelled by me. For you are my supreme refuge. Lakshmana, you should tell the king who rules his own conduct by being steadfast in Dharma. You should tell him, you should conduct yourself towards the citizens as you would conduct yourself towards your brothers. This is your supreme duty, and you will earn endless fame by the meritorious deeds that you do. O king, I do not grieve for this body. And I urge you that you should conduct yourself in such a way that the citizens will cease spreading scandals. And towards that, if this is what it is to be, let it be. Although she doesn't use this word, this is what she means. If this is what is to be, let it be. To me, the king is my God, he is my friend, he is my mentor, and therefore he should do what pleases him, sacrificing even my life if need be. That, in brief, is what you should tell Rama from me. And Lakshmana, before you go, take a good look at me. For I am in the family then.
Evam ruvantyam sitayam lakshmano dina chetana shirasa vandya dharani vyahartum na shashaka pradakshinam chatam prutva rudhannevu mahasuna Dhyatva muhurtam tama kimvam vakshati shobhane.
When Sita said this, Lakshmana was dina chetana, as too heartbroken, too miserable to speak. He simply put his head on the ground and he was not able to speak. Then he got up and he circumambulated her, he did pradakshinam of her. And then he asked her, Kim maam vakshati shobhane. Oh, auspicious one, what are you asking me? What can I tell you?
Drishtapurvam nate rupam padu drishtau tava naghe kathamatrai vashyami rameena raidamvane. Tapurvam nate rupam padu drishtau tava naghe.
I have not seen your form in my life earlier. I have not lifted my eyes to see you All I know of you is your feet. And you are asking me to have a look at you, and now at the time when even Rama is not here, in a forest, what are you asking? At that time in Kishkindha Kanda, when they were in search of Sita and Sugriva and others in the mountains at Sati, there was this lady and all these ornaments and clothes she had thrown down when she was being dragged across the sky by a Rakshasa, and then I have kept it safely. Maybe it is Sita. Can you have a look at these jewelry and this and see if this is what this belongs to Sita, etc.? They had brought it, and Rama had asked, let's not have a look at it. And he said, how will I know? The only thing I know is her Nupura, the anklets. That's the only thing I've seen. So, saying this, he prostrated himself full length to the ground and then got up into the boat and asked the boatman to leave, to take off. Other side, Sumatra is waiting the chariot, the candles. Today is his star, Lakshmana star, Ashlesha. So he reached at the bank, he got into the chariot, he was beside himself, laying down with the burden of his grief. Muhur muhur paravrityat dhritva sita manathavat cheshtante parade rastam lakshmana prayavat. He couldn't go immediately. He kept coming back again and again to look at Sita and the other bank. Unfriended, alone. She was convulsed there with bliss. This is going on, Valmiki. Like when you drop off your baby the first day in school and you wait till you see inside. Somebody come and take him by the hand or her by the hand and take it inside. Still you are waiting 5 more minutes in case it was crying outside. This thing is going on, looking. Durastham Rathamalokya Lakshmanam Jamurmu Nirekshamanam Tuttad Vignam Sitam Roka Samavishate. And Sita, was there and fear was clutching her heart apparently. Suddenly there was fear. And she was looking across the river at Lakshmana, there the chariot. She was overwhelmed with grief, started weeping aloud. There was no one, no solace at that point in time. Only sounds other than a loud weeping with the clamor of the peacocks, as Valmiki. But there were eyes watching. And soon, Sitaam Turudatim Drishtva Tetratra Munidharaka Pratraman Yatra Bhagavan Aste Valmiki Ugradhi. Valmiki's ashram was nearby. That's exactly where Rama had asked her to be, quote unquote, abandoned. So, ashrama, there are other ashramas there, and the rishis, sons, children, some of the youngsters there had been watching this lady who is crying alone at the banks of the Ganges, and they ran to the sage. Blessed sage Valmiki. Valmiki of rigorous austerities, he was there, they went to him, they prostrated and they told him, there is a woman weeping. Adrishtapurva Bhagavan Kasya Pyesha Mahatmana Patni Shri Rivasam Moha Dirauti Vikatarana. Adrishtapurva, a lady whom we have not seen before. Bhagavan, kasya pyesha mahatmana. Some mahatma's wife, but we don't know who. This must is, can make a royal mahatma's wife.
Patni, Sridiva Sambhuha. She's as beautiful, Sridiva. She's as beautiful as Goddess Lakshmi. As glorious. And she's crying, she's weeping. Vikritanna. Her face is twisted by her crying. Crying is a bit tough on the face. It's not a beautiful thing. Her face is Vikritanna. So then they tell Bhagavan Sadhu Pashyestvam Devatam Iva Khachyutam Nadyatu Tire Bhagavan Manastriga Vidukkita Dishtasmadhi Prurithatudam Shokaparayana. Bhagavan Sadhu Pashyestvam Devatam Iva Khachyutam. Sir, you must see her. You must see her. She is like a goddess who has fallen down from the sky. She is Jogi, some Varastri, some very, very high personage. She is. But she is in Kavi Dukkita. She is in great sorrow. And we saw her and she is weeping aloud. Anarha Dukkha Shokabhyam Ekam Deenam Anathat. Anarha, she doesn't deserve to be like this. She is alone all by herself and she is Anatha. She has nobody with her. And she does not deserve this suffering. And she is ekam, alone, dinam, she is miserable. Na yena manushi vidma. We don't think she is mortal. She is not, she doesn't look human being. She doesn't look like a human being, she looks like a goddess. Sir, we must show her hospitality. She is not far from the ashrama and she is evidently seeking your protection. Tell me.
Tradaram ichchate sadhvi. Bhagavan Tratu Marasi,
she is looking for some Tratar, some protector, and Bhagavan, you must protect her. They tell Valmiki.
Tesham Duvatanam Sutva Buddhyani Chitya Dharma Viditapasa Labdha Chakshushman Pradravat Yatra Maithini.
Having heard them,
Valmiki, Dharma Vidhi, who knows Dharma, Tapasa Labdha Chakshushman, who had the eyes. Not these eyes. He had the further eyes which are got by tapasya,
which could see what I cannot see. He had that. He got up and he pradhavat. Very quickly, maybe like in a trot, he went to where Maithili was. He got up and went there. Has his disciples seeing him go, they ran.
Mahamatim, the great mind of the great intellectual Valmiki, was followed by his people who had brought the news to him and others. They went quickly towards the place and he was taking with him argya offerings that should be given to an honored guest when the guest comes to your house. There's a standard tradition in ancient India how you actually welcome a guest. So there's argya, bhajya, mudupatkam, there's several things that you do. Right now he is going with Arghya, water to welcome her. And he reached the bank of Janavi Ganges and he saw Rama's wife standing. She was Anathvat, she was there.
Tam Sitam Shoka Bharartham Valmikir Muni Bungala Uvacha Madhuram Vanim Radhayan Nivadetasa. Now the next set of words is, I will tell you the verses as well. Normally, I try to skip, but then I tell the verses as well because they're very, very nice and they give a reflection of the height of culture 5,000 years ago. Culture of speech, culture of thought. Tohi. Valmiki spoke gently to her. He said, Tam Sitam Shoka Bharartham. She was weighed down by sorrow and he went to her, the greatest amount. Munis, he went to her and he spoke her Madhuram Vani, sweet words.
sweet voice, Kladayanyava Tejasa. So that to gladden her by his powerful speech, whatever it is. Saint, he comes and he tells her,
Snusha dasarasasya tvam, Ramasya maishi priya, Janakasya sutha ranya swagatam te pativrate.
He's not asking her, who are you, why are you crying, who brought you here, why are you alone, nothing. He says, you are the daughter-in-law of Dasaratha. You are the beloved queen of Rama. You are the daughter of the king Janaka. Welcome, O Pativrata. O chaste Sita, welcome. I think he's got her attention.
Ayanti chasi vinyata maya dharma samadhina karanam chaiva sarvam mendriyeno palakshitam.
Even as you are coming, I knew that you were coming. By the power of my dharma samadhi, translated as the power of my yogic meditation, but the word used here is dharma samadhi, not just samadhi. The power of the meditative meditation rooted in dharma. By that power, even as you were coming, I knew you were coming, and not just that, I also know in my heart of hearts the reason for your coming.
Tavajaiva mahabhage viditam mamatattvatah sarvam cha viditam mahyam trailoke yaddhi vartate. Tavajaiva mahabhage viditam mamatattvatah.
She is saying, I am dukkha bhagini. He is calling her mahabhaga. She says, I am the wretched, miserable, unfortunate one. Fortune was never mine. I was not built for good fortune. This body is meant for sorrow. And he says, one more, great good fortune. Mahabhaga. Oh Mahabhaga, I know the whole truth about you. In fact, I know all that is to be known in all the three worlds.
Apapam vedmi chite tvam tapolabdhena chakshusha visrabdha bhavavaidehi sampratam mai vartase.
Apapam vedmi chite tvam, I know you to be sinless. By the power of that, by the power of the eyes that I have because of tapasya, I know that you are sinless. I can, that the sages see. The sages who are established in the self see you. They don't see you. They see your punya and your papa and visibility. They can see all. Since I know you to be sinless, so be easy in your mind, Vaidehi. Sampratam mayi vartase. For the time being, you shall be living with me.
Ashramasya vidure me tapasyasta patisthita tastva matse thavat sampadishyanti nityacha.
My ashrama is right here, and not very far from my ashrama is the ashrama of lady anchorites, tapasis. I will take you there. There are lady sages in that ashrama. You will live there, and they will look after you, they will protect you, my child, as one looks after one's own child. ఇదమధ్యం తేజత్వం విశ్రద్ధా విగలజ్వరా యథా స్వగ్రహమప్యేత విషాదం చైవ మాకటా.
Accept this again, water of welcome, Sita. Be free of despondence, be free of any worry, be free of any anxiety. Treat this as your own home. This is your home. This is the words of welcome that he tells, because of the time taken to read the verses and convey the meaning, it has taken longer. It would have been over in a flash what he had conveyed to. From that moment to this moment, there's a sea change as far as Sita is concerned.
శ్రువా భాషితం సీతా మునే పరమమద్భుతం శిరసా వంద్య చరణం తథేత్యాహ కృతాంజలి.
శ్రువా భాషితం, హియరింగ్ ది వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ముని విచ్ ఆర్ పరమం అద్భుతం, వెరీ వండర్ఫుల్ ఆర్ ఓ ఇన్స్పైరింగ్ వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ ది మహర్షి వాల్మీకి. షి హర్డ్, షీ కుడ్ డూ నథింగ్ మోర్ దెన్ హోల్డ్ ఆన్ టు ఎ సీట్. షీ గాట్ అప్, హ్యాండ్స్ ఫోల్డెడ్.
It shall be as you wish, she said, Tathet. And the sage said, follow me. And they went. She followed him with folded hands. He took her straight to the ashrama of the tapasis, the lady anchorites. He took her there. And they came out gladly to receive them. And they said to Valmiki, Swagatam de Munishrestha Chirasya Gamanam Chade Abhivadayamas Tvam Sarva Uchyatam Kincha Kurmahe Sarva Uchyatam Kincha Uchyate Kurmahe. Swagatam de Munishrestha.
Welcome, great sage, they said. The anchorites said, the lady anchorites said to Muni, welcome, great sage. It's been a long time since you came here.
Chirasya Gamanam Chade. Not that far, nearby ashrama. He's in his mind, there and there, but so they haven't come for a long time. Welcome, they tell him. We bow to you, we make our prostrations to you, but please tell us what you want done. Because they can obviously see he's bringing somebody. So he tells them, Siteyam samanuprapta patne ramasya dhimatah స్నుషా దశరథస్థేజానకస్య సుతా సతి అపాపా పతినా త్యక్తా పరిపాల్యా మయా సత. షీ ఇస్ సీత, షీ హస్ కమ్ హియర్, షీ ఇస్ రామస్ వైఫ్, షీ ఇస్ దశరథాస్ డాటర్ ఆఫ్ జనక, షీ ఇస్ ఫర్ నో రాంగ్ ఆఫ్ హర్స్. She has been abandoned by her husband. And I have a duty to protect her, always. She has to be protected by me forever. పశ్యంతు స్నేహన పరమేణ హి గౌరవాన్ మమ వాక్యాచ పూజ్యావోస్ విశేషత.
అండ్ లేడీస్, యూ మస్ట్ ప్లీజ్ లుక్ ఆఫ్టర్ హర్ ఫర్ మీ, అండ్ యూ మస్ట్ యూ షుడ్ షవర్ హర్ విత్ ఆల్ అఫెక్షన్, అండ్ షీ షుడ్ హ్యావ్ ఆల్ ది ఆనర్ అట్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్స్. Not just because out of your regard for me, and that I ask you to do so, not just because of that, but more importantly, visheshata, because of her own status and dignity. That's who she is. Saying this, he entrusted Vaidehi to the care of the tapasis with repeatedly
injunctions telling them, must take care of, a proper life. All that he told 3-4 times to them. And he left her in their care and he went back to his ashrama. So they had walked back into the forest from the banks of the Ganges into the forest. And Lakshmana was watching all that from the other side. You're still miserable. He'd been asked to do a job, like a head job. Very, very bad. And the charioteer Sumantra, Mantra Sarathi, charioteers are counselors. That's what it means. Mantra Sarathi. His name itself is Sumantra, one who gives good counsel. Always charioteers are counselors. Sumantraji, he tells him, look at this sorrow that has come upon Rama. Look at this sorrow as a result of this separation from Sita. Having sent away Sita of unblemished conduct. What greater sorrow can be there for Rama?
Vyaktam daivadaham manye raghavasya vinapavam vaideya sarade nityam daivam bhituradikramam.
It is clear to me that it is fate which is the cause of Rama losing Sita. And it is clear to me that there is nothing stronger than fate.
यो हि देवान् सगद्धर्मान् असुरान् सहराक्षसैः निहन्या राघवत् बुद्ध सदैवं पर्युपासते यदो हि देवान् सगद्धर्मान् असुरान् सहराक्षसैः निहन्या राघवत् बुद्ध सदैवं पर्युपासते
दैट रामा हु कुड टेक ऑन द देवान् द गंधर्वान् द राक्षसान् हि कुड डिफीट देम ऑल इन बैटल द असुरास हि कैन हि कुड डू ऑल दैट बट दैट रामा व्हेन इट कम्स टू फेट Paryupasate, he has to sit in worship and soul that he cannot do a thing. In the olden days, Rama lived in the forest, had to live in the forest for 14 years obeying the directions of his father. But the grief, where there was no grief. This is grief. If that was suffering, that was no suffering compared to this. And he doing this because he is the object of gossip among the citizens. It is cruel. It seems cruel to me.
कोणधर्माश्रयसूतकर्मण्यस्मिन्यशोहरे मैथिलीं प्रतिशं प्राप्तः पौरैरीनार्थवादिनः
ओ हि कोणधर्माश्रयसूतकर्मण्यस्मिन्यशोहरे व्हाट कॉज ऑफ धर्म इज सर्व्ड बाय व्हाट रामा हैज डन यू टेल मी ओ चैरिटर व्हाट इज व्हाट धर्म दिस थिंग दैट इज डन इज ओनली समथिंग व्हिच इज गोइंग टू ब्रिंग यू अ बैड नेम फॉर हर टाइम टू कम यशोहरे His reputation is destroyed. And he has done this, it has been undertaken because of his deference to the unjust accusations of the citizens of Sumantra. Look at this.
Hearing Lakshmana speaking this strange, Sumantra told him, you should not grieve on Maitali's account or Saumitri. This has been foreseen in the far past. Long past,
Where the Brahmanas were with your father, Lakshmana, this has been foreseen.
Bhavishyati dhidham rāmo dukkha prāyo visaukhya bhāga prāpsate ca mahābhāho vipriyogam priyayidhutam.
They told him that Rama was dhidham rāmo dukkha prāyo visaukhya bhāga. Rama was bound to experience practically nothing but grief. And that Rama would know little happiness. And he of mighty arm would certainly, absolutely, surely he would suffer separation from those that he loves.
Tvam chaiva maitrim chaiva shtatrugna bharatodata satya jishyati dharmatma kalena mata mahan.
In the years to come, this mahatma will abandon. Not just by three, he will abandon you, he will abandon Bharata, he will abandon Shatrughna. In the long years to come is the power of Kala. I heard this in the presence of your father, the king. And the king was told not to mention this to anybody. He was told not to mention this to you. Or to Rama, or to Shatrughna, or to Bhagavan. This is told by the sage Durvasa to your father. He said these things to the king when I was present along with Vasishtha. And when we heard this, the foremost of men, the king turned to us and turned to me and he said, you must not tell this to anybody. Mantra is also secrets. Sumantra is a keeper of secrets. You should not tell this to anybody. The king gave me the order. I am firmly resolved that I should never go against the words of the ruler of the world. In fact, I should not have mentioned this in your presence at all. But if you are anxious to hear, even though the king imparted to me as a secret, I shall tell you. And you should know that fate cannot be bypassed. And you should not reveal this to Bharata or to Shatrughna as to why Rama has come to experience this grief at all. Which I was listening to. An interview with a industrialist in Ranipet about his experiences with Kanchi Mahadeva. Very nice one. Sampadayika. There are two parts. It's in two parts. It's in Tamil. Mostly in English. But mostly in Tamil, some English. Very nice. Powerful one. US return educated man. Runs an industry, chemical factory. By some reason he came and died. And he was caught in the net like that he was. Such a person that he says since 1984, 14 years, he gave up his body in 1994 at the age of 100 almost. The first moment that he had come to him, or he had been called to him, to the end. For those 14 years, every Saturday, Sunday, he was, with his life, he was in Kanchipuram. Every Saturday, Sunday. very nice, powerful interview, but the point I was trying to make comes here. He says, he says very clearly, there are different relationships that you have with God. He had a very special one. Very, very open, very, very transparent. Talk anything you want, I talk to you any way you want, you can talk to me any way you want. Absolute compassion, surely, kind of thing. And total compassion. It's incredible, you must hear it to believe what that kind of relationship was. But however, simple guy like you and me. So there he was, and then he said, every once in a while, Barbara had asked him that, you know, so many people come and ask me so many things, you don't ask me anything. Ask me something. He said, what can I ask? What is there for me to ask? Something. You must ask. No. Side story is, one day some Ramanas and Kanchi would land up in his house. They were there, standing there. He said, Kanchi Mahapriya sent the Shaligram for you. One Shaligram for you to worship, and they kept it there, and they started chanting the Vedas, and they say, he said, hey, wait a minute, wait a minute, finish the chanting. He said, but I am not accepting it. He said, what? We don't know whether you are accepting, not accepting. He has told us, give it to you, we are giving it to you, we are going to do what you want. So they went off. And they went up and told him. So next time he had gone, we 3-4 days later, to very well, he said, I believe you said you are not going to accept the Shaligrama that I sent you. Why? No. Not like that. Do you know what Shaligrama it is? This is Hayagriva Shaligrama. Yeah. You are undergoing a lot of difficulties now, it is good for you. You worship it. He said, I have never told him any difficulties, I am undergoing. But my factory had burned down, all the things that happened. I said, that is okay, but I don't want this. I don't know how to worship this, I will not do it properly. There are house, all kinds of people come and go, and it won't be done properly. There will be no. Hey, what is that? Our house people only are coming. Then he said, taught me, saying, don't be afraid of God. What kind of relationship do you have? Vaishnava, you must be in love with God. What are you talking? So he said, okay, 22 days. So that's not the story. So did this. So he says, one day, I think it's very close relations, maybe his sister, I don't know, I forgot now, somebody's son, something, young man in Bombay, he's starting the electric train, and As it happened, he must have been hanging near the door, and his head hit the one lamppost or some post when the train was traveling. And he hit it and he felt deeply injured. And their family knew this man is all the time at the company master. So they don't please go tell Acharya. He's admitted in the hospital. He said, yeah, so he quickly went and he, along with his wife, he went, and there's a big queue that day, it seems. So they're sitting there, big queue. So he joined the queue and he would get immediate audience. They'd speak, he'd speak for long with him, call him inside. He had a very special relationship, so he's going there. So he's talking to everybody, and then their chance comes, and he goes in front of him and just says that my son has got hit by a train. Like that, he starts saying, yeah, Parvathana clamps down, he's gone. His eyes stop blinking, he stops talking, doesn't acknowledge him. He's gone into what is called Kashtamon, like a wood, like a log. He's gone, he's no sense of his, he's not going to respond to anything external, nothing. No, how to do. So he goes to Udupariya, Jayendra. He says, what happened? He says, no. Anyway, you must come. Please come and see. Suddenly he's Hey, what happened? What happened? He said, no, this is what happened. I told him this about my. But as soon as I said this, he came and looked at me and said, yeah, he's in the class tomorrow. Do one thing, he don't tell your people that he didn't respond. I'll give you kumkum, you send it, saying, Acharya, day, send it, go away. Two days later, the boy died. So he had gone to Bombay, he says, he was there for 13 days, whatever. After the period was over, he came back, maybe a fortnight later, he went again to meet the Acharya, and this time he was talking. Karyam Ayata. All the lights are over. He said, he didn't send any message. Anything he asked me to do. He said, see, you came that day. You feel me hurt by me? And you feel what is there? No, you never asked me anything. In fact, I ask you, why are you not asking me anything? You don't ask me anything. One day you came. Ask something, and I clamped up. I didn't say anything. You must be hurt. No, I'm not. What can I say? Listen. Whatever you do, don't get taken in by somebody who says you do this, you do that, you do this, you do that. Whatever you do, karma will not leave you. Karma will not leave you. Be assured that a boy is in a very good state. Must go. Nanraj, what could I have told you that day? What could I have told you? I had no face to tell you anything that day. Rama, to go on the Devas, the Gandharvas, the Rakshasas, the Asuras, but when it comes to fate, that's called it. It's called the power of karma is called Adrishta. Unseen force. It's unseen. You cannot see, but obviously it is there because things don't happen the way you want it, right? So why? But there is a third force. Is unseen. Tamil Adrishtam means good fortune. Adrishtam. Adrishtam is unseen. Adrishtam. Daivam also it's called. Fate. So, on that note we conclude here. So, where are we? We are at the point where Sumantra is just about to tell Lakshmana that story behind why Rama has is destined to suffer. That note will conclude here. Harinava Parvati Padaye.